Dear friends, I'd like to alert you for the pending and coming tragedy in Venezuela. Probably a situation of civil war, the destruction of life, famine, and a disaster for the subcontinent, and of course a disaster also for all democracies in the world. What is at stake is basically a war in search of controlling natural resources. This is not a war for restoring democracy. It's a war for regime change. Regime change replacing regimes that have been trying to be more nationalistic, to have more control over their resources, natural resources, and replace them by governments that are neoliberal friendly and countries that are friendly to the United States, to the US transnational corporations, particularly in the field of oil and energy in general. As you know, Venezuela has the largest reserves, oil reserves in the world. And in 2017, as a recent book published by an ex-CIA agent reports, in 2017, Donald Trump came to the CIA and asked them, why are we not at war with Venezuela, since they have all these oil reserves and are just in our backyard? This was the question. And the result, the response is this. It's real intervention that can take different forms. Of course, not necessarily the military, as you can see, could be to other forms of coups, constitutional coups, as it has been the case in the continent. But basically, is an access to natural resources. There is a crisis, a humanitarian crisis. It is calculated that 30% of the Venezuelans can only eat once a day. But this crisis is produced basically by the embargo. The embargo is one of the most radical imposed by the United States. So much so that even if the companies, some Venezuelan companies, can sell oil in 1 month or during 1 or 2 months, the revenues of those sales are not available to the legitimate Maduro government. They will be frozen and be at the disposal of self-proclaimed president with no legitimacy, Juan Guaido. Then this is really the embargo that is producing this situation. Of course, there were some mistakes and errors, and we have been critical of many of the political moves of Nicolas Maduro. But the idea is that they should be solved by elections and by the Venezuelans. And here, I think it's very important, there are forces in Venezuela. They've been trying for a long time to be critical of Maduro, but now as critical of Guaido. For instance, saying that what they have done in the National Assembly recently, declaring this state of transition or this government of transition is a parallel state, using an article of the Constitution 333 in a completely arbitrary way. And therefore these groups are groups like this Citizens Platform that are asking for a referendum, a consultative referendum on the possibility of elections for the presidency, for the government, and also for the National Assembly. So this is a kind of a democratic solution that, as we have seen in Syria, they are the moderate, so-called moderate democratic opposition that is going to be sidelined by the radicalization of the situation. And they are there, of course, against an intervention of the United States, supported supposedly by the international community. This is not true. This is not true. It's the United States and the European Union. And in fact, less than one-fourth of the countries of the general with seats in the General Assembly of the United Nations. So much so that the institutions that usually deal with humanitarian aid, they are the United Nations institutions, the Red Cross and the Caritas, for instance, have decided not to participate in this humanitarian aid that they consider a circus. So therefore, I think that we have to bear in mind that there is no international community here. There is hypocrisy on the part of the European Union, is the most shameless type of hypocrisy. Because on one side, in a recent conference on security and on Iran in Varsovia, for instance, in Poland, the United States, the European Union didn't really participate in any relevant form in that conference, precisely because they decided that any possible war against Iran is against international law, and we should respect international law and international treaties. But on the other side, on the other hand, the European Union is the same that is trashing the international law to recognize this puppet government of Juan Guaido, or Johnny Guaido, as he is known in Washington, trained for a long time to be really a president at the service of the United States. So this double standards by the European Union is very clear. The European Union needs the Iran oil and to maintain the flow of energy from Iran to Europe, and doesn't need in the same way from Venezuela. And that's why all the principles of constitutional law and of international law are really invoked whenever they serve the interests of these countries. So I think that we should really struggle for democracy in Venezuela, and the conditions for democracy is the end of the embargo, and then let the Venezuelans try to solve the problems internally. For instance, there is a proposal for a referendum, a consultative referendum, on the possibility of general elections, not only for the presidency or the government, but also for the National Assembly. So there are concrete proposals to solve this problem and to manage a situation that will be avoiding the tragic situation of civil war. I think the United States have decided that they have to destroy this country, if that is the price that Venezuelans have to pay in order that the multinational corporations have access to the oil reserves of Venezuela. This is tragic. It's a tragedy for the United States. It's a tragedy for democracy. It's a tragedy for the continent. I'd like to see Bernie Sanders, for instance, that just announced to be a candidate to the presidency of the United States, to have a very strong position against this intervention in Venezuela. I think it's very important for the safeguard of democracy in the world in the future. So we would like to show and demonstrate our solidarity with all these magnificent people that are the Venezuelans, that have this strong feeling of defense of their own homeland against interference, and to solve the problems as Mexico and Uruguay have already suggested and proposed a negotiation that would allow for the prevalence of democracy and a peaceful solution, because the alternative is civil war, destruction of lives, as we have seen in Iraq, in Libya, and in Syria.